And welcome everybody! We're back with the road to the Frankfurt Major 2015 for Empire. This is gonna be the first true test here against Pro Dota Gaming, a team that has been around for some time. Not the longest one, of course, but still. This is gonna be the toughest game so far. With me again is, of course, Morality Class, man. You ready for it?
I certainly am, and I will. And I'm looking forward to this one because, well, we haven't really seen a true challenge for Empire yet, and this might just be that game where Empire have to tell themselves, maybe this won't be so easy.
Indeed, so because far, this team has been pretty consistent. 5 seconds
remaining. But already Empire, once again, picking up the Doom as they go. Reserve time. They definitely like their Dooms, that's for sure, and of course he's been very relevant these last few days, but Pro Dota Gaming know this, and they pick up a Shadow Fiend and a Tusk as well, taking the Shadow Fiend away from Team Empire. Can't see what Team Empire's second pick is.
It's actually not taking it away from them.
Because I can't see what.
No,
they can't
stats,
really see.
Actually, because for Pro Dota Gaming, they have picked up Shadow Fiend 3 out of 4 times.
But they're pretty consistent with Shadow Fiend then.
Yeah.
Alright then, I can't see Team Empire's second pick.
It's the Winter Wyvern. You got the arrows again.
No, not the arrows. It's not there. well. Alright, Winter Wyvern and Doom. Alright, so
essentially, the hero that you go on with Tusk is going to get Cold Embrace, live through most of it, and then hope to reinitiate from the Cold Embrace, or at least keep him alive on that one.
Although, Tusk was picked after Winter Wyvern, so that was a conscious choice by Pro Dota Gaming, knowing that if the Winter Wyvern does it well, she very well just stop the Tusk gank. They're relying that Winter Wyvern won't be everywhere at once, which of course she won't be.
Yeah, that's it. If you go into Winter Wyvern herself, she needs to pre-cast it as well, and no, it's not the biggest thing, it's just something that can be really annoying. When you're Tusk, you try to go for someone, because your big burst is, in the end, is the physical Warwar Sponge, which gets neglected by...
What is love?
Oh, yo, big, hey, sorry. Dude, what is love? Dude, your mixer again.
My soundboard, I have forgotten to turn that one off.
Why is it always the same song as well?
Because it's on my slash key for some reason. I don't even know.
Oh my god. Oh. Well, baby, no love. Oh my god.
Now it's off now, okay. So.
And our Team Empire, they take out the Alchemist here. This hero is just so annoying. The gold gainer name is ridiculous. That said, always when you see him play, he needs to be so far ahead to be actually relevant. That's the one thing I always feel with an Alchemist, you always need to be ahead. If you're not ahead but an Alchemist, you just have this liability in your team.
Well, No, keep talking, please.
Oh, I just want to say that they, for Pro Dota, they ban out the Ember, the TA heroes that have been coming back a bit more lately. As well,
Ember, mostly though, because of PL, really.
Well, PL hasn't been seen as often.
Yeah, because of his, how we say, nerfs.
Yeah, it's nerfs.
They weren't really, like, too hard, but his agility game being decreased once again is just, you know, a bit too far, probably.
Well, he's still getting picked up and still a pretty viable hero, but yeah, it's just not as viable anymore, that's more it.
Like, comparison to something like an Alchemist or...
Who now becomes
still
viable,
something, you know, like...
Sometimes.
Doom is really the Earthshaker as well.
Witch Doctor, Pro Dota Gaming has also been picking up Witch Doctor pretty consistently as well.
Yeah, I mean, he's also a versatile hero. I'm surprised I haven't seen him more, to be honest, because really he wasn't really touched in the last patch, and
we saw him. He's touched. The bouncer level 3 of Death Ward is gone, but instead they have increased the damage of it on all levels.
I mean, you know, it's a slight buff to the Death Ward, but also a slight nerf, so really it sort of balances itself out. You can say that it's still the same Witch Doctor, because Death Ward's impact is still the same.
Yeah, it's still big.
Yeah. So really not much of a buff nerf to him, so I'm surprised more teams have... did we? I don't remember.
Yeah, Empire picked it up. One game. I'm not completely sure.
I believe I was gone then.
You might have been.
I did not see that.
Let's see... Empire, they picked it up in the third game. I think you joined in them, right? No, that was the one you completely missed.
Yeah.
Let's see.
Well.
Yeah, Prodota game, and they've picked up the Witch Doctor four times now, and as well as the Spirit Breaker four times. So Team Empire did some reading, and that's why they banned out the Spirit Breaker there.
Yeah, really, they don't want to play games. They're just you know, comfort bans. I think as EG, like, someone, I think it was Fear from EG, put it after TI5, you need to pick heroes that you're comfortable with and not just... No, it was Arteezy, exactly. Arteezian is a discussion of the pick and ban phase, that you need to pick heroes which you're comfortable with and not only those who are viable against the other lineup. Banning out comfort heroes, but prohibiting exactly that.
As well as heroes, actually Spirit Break is pretty viable. We've been seeing it coming back
again, yeah. Time to time.
Razor was also picked once by Pro Dota Gaming, so.
But the Upshaker pick, I feel like they were expecting them to pick up a PL.
Even then, if you don't pick it up, Earthshaker is still strong hero, long range, initiation. Shadow Fiend will need to have a buddy now in mid. So
as a quick question, since I can't see it, what's the fourth pick for Team Empire?
It's the Razor.
Okay, Razor.
You and your Arrow Gaming.
I can actually send the screenshot later again.
I saw it, the one from yesterday. If you guys want to see it as well, just go to @morality_class. You will be able to find it there.
Pretty funny. Actually, once they pick the heroes, the text fields go away and actually turn into the hero names. But, you know, before that, it's just weird. Anyway. And they pick up a Clockwork. All right. So we have an off lane, we have a mid, and we have I'm going to say a roaming support and a lane support. All they need now is a carry.
Yeah, for Pro Dota Gaming, let's see. Previously they have picked up the Luna three times, then the Wraith King once.
Wraith King would actually not be bad here. Stacking a lot more stuns on here, a lot more control.
The one thing is against it is that you have your Cox in your own team, which can be against you.
Yeah, that is a plus point, but...
And you're against the Razor. Even if you come back again, the Razor still has all the damage.
So there's the disadvantages, but Luna... Luna gets blown up easily in the early game. That's
yeah,
the
as
problem.
Well as they have things that go through BKB already. Like a bunch of
Doom,
things, actually, so...
The Razor...
Winter Wyvern Ultimate, yeah. If it's casted on her. Course.
But that's already wasting like 3 seconds of a BKB, which is great.
Yeah, and Team Empire, no, they really read into this one. They did.
Like, no,
these are really just consistent bans against them.
Like, we know you were like picking Luna. We know that you probably perform well with a Luna. You know what? We're not going to let you pick a Luna.
Yeah, as well as
and,
the Spirit Breaker.
And, you know, the rest are just, you know, standard bans. It's an Alchemist ban, it's standard. Queen of Pain ban is standard. Darkseid ban, less standard, but, you know, sometimes
you need
it.
It's pretty standard at the moment. The hero's pretty strong with the buffs it got. I think Iron Shell can't go buff or something else, but...
Oh dear, Team Empire picking up a Broodmother. And they have the Earthshaker as well.
Yeah, there is some... Clear here, but there is no good chase after him. The Clockwork is okay-ish, but still, he doesn't want to go alone versus Broodmother usually, at least not when he's ahead. So
use Rocket Flare to try and clear up the Spiderlings, but
we might see a Rocket Flare max build here.
Tusk shards also work as well, so you know they have their options to get rid of the Spiderlings, but you know, like you said, actually killing the Broodmother could prove difficult.
Yeah, they will have to. That means that they, with the Earthshaker, most likely going to be rotating around.
Yeah.
You're going to be running 2-2-1 lanes. Like, you're going to be forced for Podota to do that. If not, you're going to either lose your mid lane or your top lane. And if you're 2 versus 1 against Broodmother, Broodmother will get space, will get experience somewhere down the line. It just rips apart, like, the early game somewhere. It just completely changes the way that you need to play it. Same with the techies, it just changes the game.
Yeah, it's a really good pick for that, because now Pro Dota can't go with their original lane strategy, because...
Well, they can.
Well, they can, but it will be much weaker. It will not be as strong as they anticipated it to be.
Yeah, Wraith King is not that that strong against a Broodmother.
I mean, you could stun her up, but you still need to keep her controlled.
In the further levels, you're not going to hit her. Incapacitating Bite gives a miss chance.
That's even better. And he's a melee hero, which means that he needs to get up in her face.
Yeah, you just give it one poke and you run away if needed.
And even then, it's a broodmother. She just goes on a web and will regen that poke before you can even get the next one off.
And then Tusk also needs to get closer. If you can get it in between the walrus punch before it gets it off, it actually has a miss chance on that one as well.
That's only the broodmother. You have to consider the rest. Like, Doom will still be around. You still have the Winter Wyvern you need to worry about.
At the moment, I just like Team Empire's draft a bit more. It's just more of this aggression, more of this annoying place as well, while still having a Doom in there. It's
also, it will completely prevent any sorts of split push. That's another thing. Not that they were going to go for it anyway, but
no, this is a five-man lineup. Or, yeah, five-man slash ganking is not push, like, not at all.
But the thing is that also the thing is like, even if they are pushing Broodmother, if Broodmother isn't dead, she'll just push her lane if she's going to do it like that. The other variant to play Broodmother is you invade the enemy jungle, which we've seen happen as well.
That's true. That's it for Pro Dota. The good thing is that they come online a bit earlier. Like, their strength is just higher at like 10 to 15 minutes when you have like the max raises, max necromancy, and you got your level 6 on your supports and on your clockwork and on your Wraith King. You can just force fights and you will most likely just win them pretty easy. Because Broodmother doesn't bring anything apart from her own lane.
Like, really, right now, any team fight will probably go the way of Pro Dota if we're just going by equal circumstances.
Indeed. The question is, what are they gonna get back for it?
Like, yeah, once after the team fight is over, after the dust clears, their push is weak. Weak-ish. It's not wrong.
There's some damage from the Wraith King and from the Shadow Fiend. We'll set some stacks up. But
and the thing is, though, they need stacks and they need items. And it's all money, you know? It's all the cash that they need.
Yeah. Late game, you always fear when you're against a Doom late game. That's the thing.
Yeah.
You have the Wraith King, so you're... You know, if he gets Doomed, it's kind of okay-ish. But...
You know, Refresher Doom is still something scary.
Yeah, that's it. People don't really rush that anymore. They tend to go for other items first.
Especially now, I'm guessing it's going to be a bit more Harry Doom.
Yeah, most likely you're going to see a drum into... What is it? Vladimir's Offering, those kind of things.
Hang on a sec. Oh, I'm on the directed camera. There we go.
Yeah, I put it off straight away before we started. That's really annoying to have. Well, let's just do an introduction while we're still paused, I guess. I'll take Pro Dota Gaming for now. We have Witch Doctor being played by Jatsu.
Yes.
Jatsu. Shravka playing the Shadow Fiend. ProX playing the Wraith King. Kev playing the Tusk. And that leaves the Clockwork on for Orbit.
Okay, and for Team Empire on the Radiant side, we have Alohadance playing the Earthshaker, Yoki playing the Razor, No Fear playing the Winter Wyvern, Resolution on that very annoying Broodmother, and Silent playing the Doom. Let's see if we can see some more Rampages from Empire coming out, or not, you know.
Yeah, I actually made the highlights, so you can just watch them on the
YouTube channel,
yeah.
The link below.
Yeah, it's in the panel, just click it. And if you're watching the video on YouTube, just go to the channel. Also, of course, the casters for now is Morality Class, of course, joining me. You can find him on Twitter at Morality_Class. I'm Sander. You can find me on Twitter at Sander_Dota. Make sure to follow us. We'll be bringing coverage of the entire Open Qualifier. At least I will. I might be joined later on today by somebody else if Morality Class isn't able to be here all day.
Should be able to.
Good, because it might go late.
okay. That could be an option. That could be an issue.
Yeah, because this is what, round 32, so there's one match. After this, you have 16, that's two. Then you have 8, so the quarterfinal, and it's another match. Then you have best of 3 semi, so that's up to 5, 6, and then another 3, so 8 to 10 matches today. So till 9 CST till 11. That's a bit more than you expected.
It's probably going to go a bit late, yeah.
So. Well. This is a pretty big break at the moment. Let's see, Jaitsu, I don't know him. See, is he in Steam right now? He is currently offline, last online 9 minutes ago. What did he play for? Let's see. Januzzi stream, here's a Viki. Let's check Dota buff.
Being all voyeur right now.
Who, me?
Yeah, it's like, let's have a look at what he's going on.
Yeah, why not? You know, we have a big thing here, so there's not a whole lot happening. So, yeah. You know, they haven't even bought their items yet. The lanes, yeah, I said, it's going to be 2-2-1 for Pro Dota, most likely. Or at least have one of the supports rotating out to help mid. For Empire, it's Resolution on top. Silence is going to be in bot. Jokey on mid, most likely going to have a lower dance rotating in there all the time. While Nofer is going to help Silent out mostly, as well as stacking the jungle. And Jokey is drawing circles on the map.
Probably designating where to block, although those are weird places where to go.
He's just doing random shit right now. He's not even sure what he's doing.
I'm not even sure what to say, really. I mean, right now we can't really do any strategic discussions, considering there's no real strategy being... I mean, Brood took Web first, of course.
Yeah, there's something weird.
Shaker took Fisher first, I guess.
And nobody else took anything like they're supposed to. You might have to use your Scorched Earth to get out as being a Doom if you get ganked at the rune or something. For Winter Wyvern is always the question, are you going to get Cold Embrace or Arctic Burn?
Dire has no AoE. Spectator chat is saying something, Dire has no AoE. That is not true. Dire has okay AoE, actually.
Yeah, they have a Shadow Fiend. You know, pretty much everything from her is AoE apart from the right clicks. There is a nice coconut bouncing around. They have a rocket flare, as well as shards plus snowball are all AoE-ish. At least less things from them. Dire has less AoE, I would say. Well, even then they still have more than enough.
Like they don't have any. They have too much AoE, like in the sense of damage wise, but they have Cold Embrace, which in itself is already amazing. Okay, what am I talking about? They have an Earthshake and a Razor.
Yeah, that does a lot. It's just that Doom, well, you can say that, you know, Scorched Earth is an AoE in the end, so...
I use Scorched Earth for the movement speed and the heal. I don't really do it for the damage.
It could be used, like, against DAs and stuff, it's fairly useful. Okay, the GG's come out. Or the GG's see well played and good luck and stuff. Whoops, that was early.
Yes, they will GG at 1 minute, not even 1 minute into the game, because they can't handle this.
Yeah, this is too much for them, man. They can't do it anymore, they can't do it, this is...
And of course, we're talking about Empire here. I mean, they can't handle the stress.
Yeah, being anyway. One of the... I would say two favorites. I think Empire or MFF is going to win the Open Qualifier. That would be the most...
Like, which other pro team is still in here?
Hellraisers.
Quite a few, actually.
Yeah, like a bunch. You can just watch it. There's like a Reddit thread on it.
Oh, there's a Reddit thread? Shit, missed that one.
Yeah, no, there's like all teams and the ones that are getting eliminated and stuff. Yeah, they know that the Resolution is here. They have a Sentry as well as does. Yeah, Resolution has to run the hell away and he knows it.
Very aggressive there. They want to make sure the Broodmother does not become an issue, but to be honest, isn't Broodmother already an issue the second she's in the game?
Yeah, she's always just annoying. Even if she's just on the lane pushing it, doing absolutely nothing else, it's still already annoying because you always need to have somebody there.
And the best part is, like, even if they do place a ward there, Broodmother can decide, alright, fuck it, I'm not going to be on the lane, I'll just invade your jungle.
Indeed, and on the die, there's some nice spaces to go to, so... Actually, already an early sentry ward from Resolution. No, this is not from Resolution, never mind, that's from the, from Pro Dota.
So, a bit of a gentleman's agreement here once again. Bounty rune going either way, and that means an even win rate here.
Just look at it. Lower dance is already mid, as the supports from BD are just stop.
Yeah, this is going to be a hard lane for the Shadow Fiend if he doesn't get any rotations. Look at this.
Did they find the ward? Yeah, this is the first chunk of vision already down with this for the dire side. Like,
with the Loha Dance here, he's not going to get souls, like, in the next minute or so.
Resolution cocked in, dust up now as well. They have to ref Fire Blast. They're gonna get it off, but Resolution is fairly tanking. He can just... Ooh, that's actually the coconut. That will seal his fate. He will die here.
So we were talking about how they didn't really have the lockdown, but here we proved exactly the opposite.
Yeah, once the shards hit and they're able to keep on damage on him, he's not able to get around it. This does mean that they're gonna go into a big... He even gets it down now. Okay, no more sent. Okay, there's still one sentry on Kev.
So what do you think he can do now as a Broodmother? Rotate down maybe and try and get some farm on his lane? You know,
hide in the bushes. Throw one down somewhere in the... I can draw here and you can, and even if I could, you can see it. Just go in
maybe
the side
to the
shop.
Left. Yeah, to the left.
To the side shop or in the by the tower. Just put one down there. And that said, you need to be level 3 to have more than 2 webs. So that's the one bad thing about it.
Like, look at this. They're just rotating around and they're just going to start looking for him again. This is not good for Resolution.
Yeah, they know where he is. If they want to bait it, they need to walk back a bit and just wait for him to walk up again. But I'm pretty sure that Resolution knows that they just put one down. And as you can see, he's already moving his webs more to the side.
I think we're having some sound lag, game sound lag, apparently.
On stream, could you check it? Oh, Fissure comes out. Second Link as well, but they're not going to be able to kill him off here.
Yeah, on stream, apparently game sound lag going on. Here we have Broodmother who decides she needs to aggressively get that carry. Clarity, that's actually pretty good. It means he will not be able to ice shard for the next few seconds.
Did you check the sound on stream, by the way?
Apparently, yeah, it's having some issues.
Okay, I will just restart the stream real fast. And welcome back. Let's hope this fixes it.
Always these weird stream issues.
Yeah, you get them from time to time.
Anyway, let's have a look at how Doom is actually doing on last hits versus the Wave King. It's not too good. 12 to 3 versus 16 to 10, but of course, Doom can be contested by the Clockwork, whereas Wave King is having a relatively good time. Oh, now Tusk is rotating out, which means Broodmother should have a bit more space here.
Yes, Alohadens will take the fall here. Nice rotation in there from Kev, but Refka is maybe lingering around a little bit too much. No, Yoki has to back off. Having 2 heroes punch him is a bit too much. There was a bit of over-aggression coming out from Alohadens, and they punished it pretty well. Resolution, is he being seen here? Oh, they can't see him yet.
Well, at least he's zapping XP, so he's got that going for him, and he has the Basilius up.
He has it actually on. That's quite kind of weird. You would most likely want to put it off so the troop base pushes towards you and not away from you. Or not even towards you, it just stays even.
I'm having a look at the Shadow Fiend. 17 souls in, so he's caught up really quickly. But he's only 6-1, which means... Yeah, he got that from a kill.
Yeah, it's all from the kill.
Yeah, so not too many great last hits. Ooh, dear Yoki, taking a lot of damage there.
Yeah, he does have the Bolo as well as a Tango, so... Gets the rune now as the DD was taken by No Fear and Bot. They want to set up something here on Trafka. Dusk is nearby, so Kev might be able to save the day. Yes, yeah, there they go. They're going to go in Plasma Field, Fissure, and the slow is there with the DD. Yoki just starts stealing damage from Kev, but he can't stay underneath the tower. The short almost killed.
But he has the bottle. Being very ballsy, though, that is risky plays. That's what I'd like to say. 400 health. Although, on level 2 Ice Shards and the level 1 Snowball will be unable to kill him unless he gets support, and now Yoki retreats.
Well, there was no fear, of course. He still had the Cold Embrace, so even if you're stuck underneath the tower, you can just heal him up with that. The Witch Doctor does have a TP, so he could have rotated in then, but that means that you're leaving the Broodmother alone and you need to have a support with him.
This Resolution is getting some levels here, so... Not the best of starts, but you know, he's got...
He starts to get some spiders now. Like, you gotta start somewhere. Broodmother at level 1 is underwhelming. Level 2 is not really much better. You start becoming something at level 5. Until then, they can still bully him around a bit as long as they keep vision on him.
Okay. And now the Soul Ring is up.
Yeah, he's going to become a little bit more annoying. Oh, they want to go straight for him now. The Snowball is going to come in. Charge there as well to block him off. Maledict. little bit late, won't really do anything, but they're still easily able to get a kill.
Only use the spiders to kill the witch doctor, but...
I don't think they would be able to do it. They even use Wraithfire Blast to it. Ooh, they need a little bit more, but these last four are just tickling him.
It was a good attempt to try and get a counter kill, but Broodmother's now died for the second time on this off lane.
Yeah, they're making sure that the Broodmother can't get anything. Now they're looking for something here on orbit. No fairies nearby as well as lower density. There you go. Go into the air, start slowing down. Fissure hits as well. And Sion just runs in with a score of Earth. Misses the Centaur Stomp here due to the battery assault. Orbit is able to get out for now as the Splinter Mass doesn't kill him off. Oh, Jaijutsu. Yeah, you're not really that tanky. As he just gets almost slipped down. What? 6 HP. Okay, they give the kill to a lower dense, or at least he takes it.
They get something in return eventually, but still, the Broodmother has already died twice, and only getting a Witch Doctor for that is... I mean, it's still good. It's an early game gank, so any kills you get is great, but, you know, the better targets out there.
Yeah, it does mean that if they rotate out the heroes like that, the Broodmother is able to farm up a bit. Resolution can go now. Take a little bit to jungle now.
Already starting to the invasion, eh?
You need to start somewhere.
And he's got a nice amount of spiders now, so yeah, there you go.
Yeah, this won't be nice for the Wraith King to deal with. That said, he has a stout shield, so he's able to block most of the damage.
But his lane is starting to get pushed out, which... Oh, here comes a smoke. And they will only find the spiders.
They dust the Broodmother as well, but... Oh, did they see him? What? There you go. Death Vision on them, Ray Fire Blast, nice to follow up. Are they able to get at least the Witch Doctor back for this? Yes, they are. He will die in the end, and they block off their own camp with the Sentry. Or at least, maybe it's actually not that bad. It means that Broodmother can farm it either.
But Broodmother's now died three times on this top lane, and now all she's gotten is a Witch Doctor in return.
Yeah, they...
So...
It's a threat. She
needs to start looking for other opportunities.
Yeah, the end result is she can't really rotate out anyway because they want to make sure that Silent can get his farm up first. In the meantime, Resolution just has to stick it out over there because going mid is not really an option either as they get the kill here on a lower dance with Orbit. Hookshot then kills him off and now they're trying to fight up against Yoki. He's going to really rotate in from Trefka as well. Yeah, oh, Yoki's trying to dodge his one around, but is he going to get capped for this? Yes, he will. Ooh, nice stick there. The raise hits. Orbit needs one poke. He's more. He actually has absolutely no damage, so even if he pokes him 10 times, it wouldn't really do a lot. They need that Trefka to hit him, but they're not able to do it. He's just too fast. Too damn speedy.
It's Razor. He goes fast. He goes fast. Static field as well. Unstable current. Any spell you cast him just makes him faster.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, they had to commit a bit more for that. I think they would have been able to get it if they. Yeah. That said, Yoki didn't make a nice dodge there.
Broodmother is still building up a spider army, but like I said, like behind.
Yeah, only 32 less. That said, it's 10 more than the clockwork has.
It's great. Oh.
Well, at least. We're able to get out most of them, but still, it's about 4 or 5 loss at least.
That was a lot of gold going the way of Wraith King, going the way of Shadow Fiend there.
Yeah, Trefka's happy with that. That gets a stack in the jungle. So, nothing wrong for there for them.
Lots of souls, already full up on the souls, and Broodmother starting to show problems. It's just starting to be a liability here, really, with that.
I think Resolution is going to go for a Midas here.
Yeah, some catch up. Oh, what a nice hook, though.
Oh, Yoki got out. It's gonna get killed. This snowball comes in. They want to get a lower dance here as well. Do they still have any shards? No, they don't. Doom comes out on the Tusk as well. Are they able to deny Kev here? Yeah, they should be able to deny him. Ooh, Fissure just off the mark. But it won't mean that he won't die here. As Wraith King is just gonna sacrifice his life here. Get the reincarnation off. They're gonna get the golden brace on the lower dance. They want to reinitiate on this, but they're fairly slow there. No fear. Yeah, he is going to be the sacrificial lamb for the rest of them to get out. It does mean that there's 5 minute cooldown or so on the Wraith King's reincarnation.
Force that out, but the problem is they got 2 kills out of that, so I'm guessing. And they're starting to push through, so good trade off for Pro Dota here.
Yeah, it's And then it's about 1100 gold and XP changes.
Oh, what a nice fish.
It does block them off at the same time, so they aren't really able to pursue it, as the cocks also make sure that they can't follow up.
Doom decides to go YOLO mode though.
Is it still lagging? What's wrong with that? I'm getting nothing here. I will just restart it again then, I guess.
That's... But you know what? All this time they've managed to leave the Broodmother alone, and oh, well, never mind. Clockwork getting a rocket off. And now they're gonna... Oh dear. Whoa, that is some deep diving from Empire going on here.
Well, I had to miss that was because it wasn't OBS. Sorry for that, the sound drop there as well. I'm gonna restart
the rest. Broodmother is pushing through the tier 1 here. Taking down the tier 1, she has space to, you know, completely just wipe out the enemy lane, the jungle. Can take over now. Critical moment for Broodmother here. In fact, she's starting to push through the tier 2 because they're not contesting. Look at the damage, just, it's pretty good, and the trade will only be bot tier 1 for the Radiant. If they can take down this tier 2, that
would be well worth it. They're actually looking to contest it. As well as Doom comes out on Kef. Oh, Silent, he's gonna get stunned up. They're gonna try and control him down as Yoki's just stealing all the damage here from Frost. And he doesn't have reincarnation, so he will just die here as well. Switchtop is taking a lot of damage. Silent is still alive. They're not able to kill him off. Now they're all stuck here and they're gonna try and turn this one around. No fear. No, he gets up the curse onto Trefka here. Oh no, he might just take foil as well. Orbit. Yeah, he dies as well. Alodens is low. They're gonna kill him off with the snowball here. But that means that Trefka will still die. Kev.
And the Razor ult.
No ultra kill here as Silent takes less kill.
And look at Broodmother, she's up to tier 3 already.
Yeah, this is the one problem. This is what we talked about. You need to make sure that you keep eyes on the Broodmother. And as you rotate out like this, you're just going to lose one tower, two tower, and then you all die. You're going to lose even more.
And you're going to lose the jungle as well, as she just decides, all right, you know what, they're all respawning. I'm going to just take your jungle instead. And to be honest, that was a completely failed attempt. They didn't even get the tier 1 out of that. It's very low, which means the next creep wave should kill it. But, you know, that was a very, very, very valuable trade-off for Empire. They came out so on top on that one.
Dude, as they're still saying that I'm lagging in the stream, the sound. Like, if it just disappears from time to time, it means because I'm all-topping. But, yeah.
Text cast instead.
Yeah. I really don't know why it is. Like, I really don't get this. Oh, hello, there's now they're gonna go in me. Threats counters with the Echo Slam, but they still don't have a reincarnation on proc, so he needs to start running already. Oh, Witch Doctor Ultimate is not able to kill him off, but the Cox will. Aloha Dance is still in there. Resolution comes in. He wants to try and kill Proxy most likely, but the Splinterless will already do so. Now Kev is on the list. Oh, he pops his hunger here. Orbit. Yeah, he's able to walk this one off.
Still, good trade-off. Oh, once again, the souls for the Wraith King. For the Shadow Fiend. So, good trade-off. They only used the Razor and the Earthshaker. Arguably, the Razor trade-off wasn't good, but they got the Wraith King for that and both supports, so... Still very good.
Yeah, now that you can see that it's becoming harder and harder to control resolution on the Broodmother here. With everything on top already down, the jungle being invaded, a web down on bot as well. She just controls the entire top side of the map here. Silent is just farming up here on bot, being the top farm with 7.1k, is building up for Radiance.
That is an item which I really like on Doom. It's very expensive and it's very greedy, but it just makes you this AoE monster.
To answer to Nectar's question, I didn't change anything. Do I still have it? Because then I'm just gonna turn down the upload bit rate. Maybe that works.
And Broodmother has... Building, yep, she's building up to the lads. She's about to finish it off. In fact, the courier should deliver the final few items. Meanwhile, on the bot lane, we're gonna have a bit of an engagement with that smoke gank here. Winter White will be the first one to fall, but then here's a good fish and hogs in from Clockwork catching in the Doom, but he immediately runs off with the Clockwork. Cannot handle the Doom on his own, so the rest of the team comes in to assist. Good thing down from Witch Doctor. Here comes the ult, getting the Razor, but the Razor's just too tanky for this. Doom runs off, the Razor gets stunned. Fisher blocking off again. Do they have another Wraith Fire Blast for this? They have 2 seconds for the Wraith Fire Blast. The Rocket coming in, dodges it barely. Gets the TP, will TP out. Now looking for the Doom. And the Doom will end up dead here. What is he doing?
Aloha dance.
He is just buying time. They're buying time. That's all they're doing. Resolution at the same time is going to take the melee Rex down. The range Rex are also taking a lot of damage. He's starting to TP in. One now is going to be the Shadow Fiend, but he has the Wormless. Resolution can just kill him if he gets too close. This is going to be at least the melee Rex for now. They're going to TP in more. But this is the Tusk. He gets off the dust. Just put the Spiralings on the range Rex. Just go for that. But he is controlling all of them at the same time, going the same way as Resolution. He's a little bit too fast, Dust still on him for 1 second. He's going to be escape. He's getting away with murder here.
He just took down the range Rex on the bot lane. Aloha Dance. They lost a lot, but they gained so much more. They just took down the Rex. The strength of the Broodmother is just overwhelming right now.
Yeah, this means that you need to have a constant guard here. Because it is just a range wreck, every poke he gives is going to be XP lost forever, HP lost forever.
Doom actually went Sanjin Yasha instead of the Radiant, so he decided to go a bit more... aggressive, a bit more damage dealing, yeah.
I thought it might be that, you know, having 3k gold, you tend to most likely go for that item then.
Maybe his last or fight, maybe losing his life in the last fight, probably this he decided, okay, maybe it's not worth it that I spend the gold on something which... Because I'm not tanky enough yet, so I get the Sanjin Yasha, that'll let me tank up, it'll give me a bit of damage, so I can survive a bit longer these fights and deal a bit more damage in all these fights, which is definitely a good choice. And Broodmother is now playing cat and mouse here.
Yeah, I also want to say something about the... that's just a guess, never mind. There's just something to say about the itemization right now on Pro Dota Gaming. They've built up a bunch of... Resolution? Oh, he's caught. They have the dust on him, yeah. They actually have five people here chasing him. You should be able to get him some way or the other. There you go. They want to still go in? Okay, Curse of on the Witch Doctor, but they don't have the damage there to kill him off. Oh, no fear. Oh, no. Shot. Yeah, this was too aggressive. He gets off the Golden Brace. Is his team going to be there to follow it up? I think they're just going to leave him behind. That's a shoot. There you go.
That was still, like... no fear should not have gone. Why... Okay, Raze activating Storm from the entrance. But no fish should have backed off as soon as he knew the Broodmother was, in fact, very much toast. I mean, trading the Broodmother for a 5-man rotation, I think that would have been okay for them. They could have survived that, they could have dealt with that, but also trading away the Winter Wyvern, not very good.
Yeah, that's the one thing they didn't have to give them. Yeah, losing your Broodmother against 5-man rotation, well, it's sad, but it's gonna happen. And I still want to go on the itemization. There are all mid-game items. Blinks, Blade Mills. Oh, they just go for Resolution. There's going to be the Golden Rest. Keep him up there. Oh, Death Ward. They need to stop this one. But how can they do it? They don't really have a long range in the stun. As a lower dance now just arrives. Now Kev. Oh, Doom's straight on top of him. They just want him dead. Oh, what? Witch Doctor is closer. This creep is just blocking Silent all the way through. No. Oh, yeah. This creep is just... So annoying for Silent today. Oh no, now Silent is caught out in all of them. They need the team to back him up right now. They're seeing damage here pretty nicely from Prox as Orbit is going to go into a lower dance who gets Golden Brace up. They're going to get the double kill here already. Now it's a 2v3 fight. A lower dance. Oh yeah, he's going to get in position with Excellent. No! Oh, the casks. It makes sure that he can't do anything.
Like lucky casks here just ruining the fight completely.
Yeah, but bouncing between creeps, bouncing between spiderlings, it's just doing what it needs to be doing, and they're gonna get killed.
It's just like that one lucky, it's the one lucky counts, like the one lucky cast right now. It's the bounces always hit you and not the targets around you. Oh, they're gonna go right in on this.
Yeah, they need to go straight up as well with Kev to defend top as it's taking damage, they know that they have their chance. Trafka, Requiem. Does some minimal damage here. It's likely just a debuff that's being applied here. That's the big thing. As they're able to get out with it.
Do they actually have a mech on the side of Empire? No, they do not. That could be actually a pretty vital flaw in their current lineup.
Yeah, going for Sanjay Yarshas instead of getting mechs on either Silent or the Yoki on Razor.
So they're going very aggressive, but the problem is they don't have the health, they don't have the burst heal.
They're still a bit ahead, they did lose a big chunk of their lead. They still have the melee Rex on top down, range Rex. took another 12 damage, so it's slowly, really, really slowly going down.
It also means that they need to consistently defend top, otherwise, they will lose it very quickly. And it looks like, once again, 5-man rotation to catch up with Resolution here, who will once again disappear into the jungle.
I would say that the next item pickup for Pro.Games should be a gem on someone. They just need to. Dance comes in, Kev, dead. Well, that's a death game.
Wraith King decided he does not want any part of that fight. He has level 2 reincarnate, so they can start being a bit more aggressive right now.
Yeah, they're gonna take this tier 2 because. Yeah, if they're gonna try and defend this tier 2, Resolution pushes in top and gets the range track, so they need to make a choice now. What, the one in 5?
He has reincarnation, remember, and they have a buyback now on Tusk as well. He decides he wants the Doom badly. Oh no, well, the Dance is going in here as well. That's a dead.
And Resolution didn't go for the split push, he was just looking at the fight, looking for a time to go in and maybe get a kill as well, as he now needs to hurry up and get the split push going before Pro.Dota is able to react to this. This is gonna lose him the tier 1 at least. As Resolution is actually opting to not go for the push, as Pro.Dota seems to be going for the Roshan.
Yeah, they can do it, they have the Wraith King, remember.
They have the Wraith King, they have the Minus armor coming out from the Shadow Fiend, they have the heal from the Witch Doctor. As well as actually, if you can get the Warlock Crunch up, it's also nice.
But hang on, this could be range racks for them though.
Yeah, this will be range racks. Resolution finally notices like, hey, they're not here, I can just take this Rex. This is gonna be the trade-off for them. As there's no way to stop this. There are no tier 2s down on mid or bot, so there's no other collateral damage.
At least they got that going for them, but... still, range now all racks down on the top lane. 20 minutes here. Thing is, can they take this late game is the question. And the answer is possibly, but the thing is they've got a very mid-gamey setup right now.
Yeah, like, the items, that's the problem.
Yeah. That said, like the Wraith King has
you're blue. Still against a Broodmother who late game does fall off. In the end, it's pretty much just Doom because Razor's... all the heroes actually fall off pretty hard. It's more like they're strong against their heroes. But they're not strong damage dealers by itself. Like, Doom can get kited around quite easily. Razor needs to get off a good static link or will do no damage at all. Broodmother is just annoying, but it's still not that scary late game hero in any sense. In that case, Wraith King as well as the Shadow Fiend are stronger or more late game oriented cores.
Yeah, because they can pick up like these big damage items like crits or butterfly. Natural build-ups for both these here. Well, not both, but I mean, just for the Shadow Fiend. For the Wraith King, you can build up a heart. You can build up a bit of a
AC. You can also build up a crit stick if he wants to, but he opts to go for the Maelstrom.
Probably going to go for the Mjolnir there.
Yeah, it's, having lost your top lane, it's probably the better item to get, just to get through there. Ooh, that hookshot just missed, but there's still no where he is. Yeah, there you go, he blinks out. Some bad camera handling there for me.
It's fine. The one aspect all us casters need to work on.
Yeah. With the MSI Dragon Battle, I have a dedicated observer, so I don't really have to care too much about it. As well as I still have a lot of bugs in the camera work here. If you do double click on the portrait, it's not as in the middle as it used to be in Source 1.
Raising it the directed camera mod thing. Well.
You have to kill us. You have to, this is the Dota 2 operator that you could use, but then you have like absolutely no control over it. And when you're a caster, you need to have control to see where it's going on. So that's really just something that you could use as an observer.
Good observing tips going on here, guys. Anyway,
hookshot missed. He still wants to go. 4 steps in.
Orbit. He won't. No.
Yeah, he's just gonna take some of the future.
He even TP'd out because he's getting blocked in by the spiderlings. And I'm looking at the net worth right now, and I'm just seeing, you know, like, it's very close on the top 5. It's incredibly close for all the top 5. Just look at that.
That said, the top 5 is occupied by 3 players from Team Empire.
One of them who one could say, like, Resolution didn't have the really good start, and yet... Still on the top chat network.
Yeah, that's
arguably Midas helping in towards that.
No, it's not arguably, it is the Midas and the towers.
Planet is the loader of Empire. Maybe. One can argue.
Yeah, the thing is though that the thing for Pro-Dota is I haven't really taken any tier 1s. The mid one is down to always be top tier 1 is still up, and the tier 1 bot lane is down. But apart from that, there's no real money that came in from that way. What? They know where Lower Dance is. Do they have vision of him straight away? No, no, they don't. Let's keep the dire vision on. Is he gonna try and catch him out? Yeah, 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 they see him now, but he blinks out. Yeah, they have no more vision. Oh, they actually do, but the hookshot is too late! He is free.
Fraction of a second too late, and he will just completely mess up the smoke. So wasted smoke right there.
And even then, you smoke up to get a kill on the Nerdshaker, who is only 5k net worth.
Which is... Okay, good trade-off for Empire, but now they need to make use some form of advantage. The problem is they can't push in with the Aegis still up on Shadow Fiend.
Yeah, they're just waiting it out. They're just pushing in all the lanes constantly to make sure that PD can't really do anything.
Like, they can't gank the jungle though, because they need to watch out top. But if they watch out top, they're gonna push in bot. Meanwhile, the carries are just farming up in their jungle. Silence about to finish off a BKB. The Winter Wyvern with a Glimmer Cape already, so she can save people a lot better now. BKB is already up on Razor as well. So the farm is starting to show, and Broodmother as well, with the BKB as well. So, already 3 BKBs online for Empire. Well, one with one about to come online for Empire. Which is really going to mess up PD strategies. Suddenly, Tusk becomes just a walking walrus punch, and that's it.
And at least they can still farm up the Spiderlings all the time.
They take care of that, you can do that.
They had to leave a couple behind.
But Broodmother is still pushing.
I guess they're not in the cliff. Yeah, they're not. Weird. Yeah, Broodmother should just go and set up shop on bot lane. You know, get just...
That's exactly what she's doing.
Yeah, this is just like the long-term goal. Get Broodmother to occupy this side of the map now. Ooh, I can draw the map. Nice. Like the bottom lane, get Rush in there as well, the Ancients, and maybe a bit of your own jungle, you know, so you can get some farm there as well. And they're gonna use him actually as a bait now, as a smoke up next to Resolution here.
They should, this is fishy though, there's no webs down for Resolution, so already Pro-Dota should know something is up.
She has two web charges, so she's able to do something, but Pro-Dota will need to defend anyhow sometime.
Yeah, no, this is really good bait actually. They're gonna go fall right into
Oh yeah, they see him now with the Observer there. Oh, what Tusk still goes in. We actually hit three of them here. Oh, they go in. Doom gets off. Who did he doom here? Oh, he doomed the Shadow Fiend. That's gonna be a dead Shadow Fiend now. Witch Doctor is getting followed here. Yeah, he will slowly die as well as here on the backline. Prox is fighting up against three. So far he's doing fairly well, but he will die eventually. There you go. Now they're gonna use the buyback on Kaffir. He goes into the snowball to save his life for a little bit longer. But in the end, it doesn't really matter. Prox comes back, they kill up another one. It's a triple kill on Yoki, and Pro-Dota just most likely just lost the game here.
That was some perfect play for the Broodmother. Unfortunately, I think the snowball was a bit of a miscommunication there. Catching up three was amazing. Problem was they couldn't do anything with that, because then the BKBs came out, then Aloha Dance's Fishers came out, then the Echo Slam. BKB or Broodmother, that's like...
The one thing about the snowball, like you see it's coming, so you just pop BKBs. Just take the fight from there.
You know, see, these BKBs are just countering Pro-Dota strategies so hard, so hard.
Yeah, the only thing they have, there are like things that go through it, but there's not enough, and they don't have enough physical damage right now. There's no fear, I might have to use this Golden Race fairly soon to heal himself up. Oh, he also has an arm. Ooh, what? Orbit. Oh, whiffed hookshot. He still wants to go. Okay, that's a little bit aggressive here. As Rain, yeah, they have more than enough vision of Orbit right now with the Warp up. Death Ward. Yatsu is looking for Death Ward from low ground here, but I don't think it will work. As Yoki's just gonna steal some damage.
There you go. Razor taking it away.
From Razor.
Silence. Silence got balls.
And just let's just take a look. Let's just take a quick look at the graphs. Yeah, over 15k, over 10k in XP. Yeah, this is gonna be troublesome for Pro-Dota. Two lanes down, this might just be the end. They need to stop this push.
Can they stop this push is the question.
Dire's middle tower has fallen. Rushes
like
up.
The BKBs. Yeah, the BKBs are off cooldown again, so
The Echo Slam will be open 13 as well. Rush is up, so they might just decide to go back for Rush or AC purchase on Yoki. Will they pursue with this?
Resolution has a Deso. Doom as well, so there's a Shivas. He's building up a Shivas. In fact, he's got enough to buy the Mystic Staff.
Yeah, it's becoming harder and harder. They have like this next set of items already.
Oh, good hook.
Fight on the lower dance, but just 4 steps out, and they're gonna try and pursue him down for now. But he has the X time, he can just pop it if he needs to. Curse comes out in proxy, just wanna lock him down here, as he doesn't have his ultimate yet. Reincarnation is still not up, so he just dies here. They took this fight too early, as they lose 3 already, and just get a lower dance in return, who was able to use his ultimate anyhow, as Silent picks up Travka on the back lines.
I don't think this is GG. They cannot. That was too much of a lead that they just gave up. Yep, there we go.
GG called. Team Empire win their 5th game. First one of today here in the Major. This is round 32, so they still have a couple of games to go before they're in the qualifier. This is @Sender_Dota. With me was, of course, @Moretti_Claus here on the Swiss DC channel. Team Empire, they take the win here. They had a little bit more trouble. This is the first plus 30 minute match. Dota was able to show some strength and resilience, but in the end it didn't work out.
Well, there you go. I mean, Dota, they had an advantage in the early game. They tried to set that advantage into the mid game with all these itemization, as you can see, but in the end Empire just took over. I mean, I think the critical point was where Resolution managing to take down both racks from them. I mean, that's just something you can't allow a Broodmother to do.
Indeed. And with that, we're just going to go into the break screen. Necto is really nice. He looked up who the next game might be. It's either going to be Priest Gaming or On Top. I would say it's going to be Priest. That's the team that I don't know. So pretty easy there. And hope to see you all again for what's going to be the second match of today fairly soon.